Welcome to SEC Network Basketball presented by Regions. It is opening night in the SEC, and the lights are going to be on at Mizzou Arena, where the number one team in the nation, the South Carolina Gamecocks, have made the trip from Columbia to Columbia to take on the Tigers, who picked up 11 wins in non-conference play. And it is great to be with you tonight with Christy Thomas-Scuddy. I'm Eric Fried. You're not so sure these days. In fact, tonight, of the seven games on the schedule in opening night in the SEC, Christy, four were canceled. So we're very fortunate to have a game here tonight.
Absolutely. The one thing that is for sure in the next month is that there is nothing for sure. And that's what these athletes understand from a year ago. But the bottom line is they want to play.
Well, while Mizzou and South Carolina are playing tonight, they are not at full strength, especially Missouri. The Tigers without five players on their roster due to health and safety protocols, including their top player, Asia Blackwell, who's averaging a double-double this season, leading the team in scoring, third in the nation in rebounding. They're also without freshman Izzy Higginbottom, who's led them in scoring twice this season. Adding to the degree of difficulty for Missouri, they are taking on a South Carolina team that knocked off six top 15 teams in going 12-0 in the preseason before SEC play, including then number two UConn in last time out, then number two Stanford coming back from 18 points down to do it. And their top player, Aaliyah Boston, keeps elevating her game.
Well, for player of the year, because in the biggest games she has shown up and shown out, averaging 17 points and 14 rebounds against those six ranked opponents. Eric, she's in the best shape of her life. She is so explosive off the bounce. All right. So if you go big, she goes by you. If you go small, she's going to post you up. And if she gets 2 feet in the paint, it is money for Aaliyah Boston.
Five straight double-doubles for the junior, who is averaging a double-double this season. Went for 18 points, 11 rebounds, and added five blocks in that victory over Stanford last time out. That was on December 21st. South Carolina is without two players. Lili Grissett and Sanaya Rivers did not make the trip to Como because of health and safety protocols. And we'll get into the details on what Missouri is going to do game plan-wise now that they have eight dressed for this game here tonight. LaDasia Williams will get her first start, former South Carolina Gamecock, playing for Missouri. And the opening tip is controlled by South Carolina, and we are underway at Mizzou Arena.
And Mizzou's going to come out with a lot of man-to-man here this evening. We'll mix it up based on who's on the floor, but Robin Pinkston believes they rebound well or better out of man-to-man.
South Carolina patiently waits to get into Aaliyah Boston, who muscles it up, and this is what Boston's going to have an opportunity to do, and that's work on the offensive glass. But Missouri scratching, clawing, that's got to be their game plan here tonight as you take a look at their starting five. Lauren Hansen having a very good second season for Mizzou. We mentioned Williams getting the start. Haley Troop has played well in a variety of roles, and Haley Frank has been very consistent. South Carolina goes with a very familiar look in their starting five. Zaya Cook, Destiny Henderson, Boston, Victoria Saxton, Bree Beal for the number one team in the country. 12-0 in non-conference play heading into this SEC opener tonight.
And Eric, you're going to see a South Carolina team that wants to play with pace. They know Mizzou wants to be methodical, wants to slow this game down. They want to get it up and down and try to score quickly.
Well, you've seen in the first two possessions how methodical South Carolina's been in the half court, and they get the open look from Bree Beal, who knocks down the three.
Well, and so many teams have been sagging off of Bree Beal because most opposing coaches feel like that's the weak link offensively for South Carolina. So a great omen to start this game for South Carolina with Beal hitting the three.
Lauren Hansen, outstanding three-point shooter. Missouri really is going to have to make quite a few threes, you feel, tonight, Christy, for them to have a chance. They're averaging eight makes a game. And Robin Pinkston, you know, this is a coach who had a ton of optimism about this game. You know, maybe it was me, not you. I'm not going to speak for you, but just like when we found out about, oh, you know, you're without Asia Blackwell, you're without Izzy Higginbottom, you're down to eight players, and you're playing the number one team in the country. But she was very upbeat about how her team has responded to this news that came down yesterday that they were going to be shorthanded.
Well, this is a Mizzou team that's been playing extremely well. Started the season with 8 straight wins before 2 tough losses to Baylor and Missouri State, and now 3 in a row. But this is a well-connected team. You can see it when you watch them. Mistake or something good happens, they are together, and that's a key piece of it in Haley Frank, who yet again draws another charge.
So Frank takes the contact. Saxton gets called for the foul. Back-to-back turnovers for South Carolina.
Frank leads as one of the top players in the country of drawing charges. Moves her feet, willing to sacrifice her body. There draws a big one.
Haley Troop trying to feed it to Williams. This will be a tough matchup inside. Williams gets called for steps before the basket. Turnover for Missouri. That is their first. Dawn Staley, 14th season as South Carolina's head coach. Great come from behind victory last time out, as I mentioned, against Stanford. Their biggest comeback win in program history, down by 18 in the first half. And another offensive foul called on South Carolina. Another charge drawn by Haley Frank.
And Eric, the charges, yes, are fouls on the opposition, but it makes players a little bit more hesitant. And I thought Frank's foot was on the arc. She rotated over from weak side. I think that's a bad call by the official.
I agree. It looked like on that replay, Christy, good call, that she was in that restricted arc. So another turnover for South Carolina. That's 3 straight turnovers. A little space there, but another miss for Missouri. Cold from the field so far. An 0-for-3 start from a team that is very efficient from the field.
And Eric, you mentioned Mizzou needs to make threes. Yes, but I think the threes they take are just as important, because long rebounds will feed into this South Carolina transition offense.
Just to clarify, 0-for-2 from 3, 0-for-4 from the field so far for Missouri. And that's Zaya Cook, third on the team in scoring at better than 11 points a game, making her 77th straight start for South Carolina.
And Eric, that last possession for South Carolina is one of the reasons why I think this is going to be a very difficult team to keep from cutting down the nets in April, because it's not just half-court offense. It is sideline out of bounds. It is underneath out of bounds execution that this team is just so dialed in.
And Williams is going to get called for the foul working against Aaliyah Boston. So take us through your keys for these two teams in this SEC opener.
Well, South Carolina's at their best when they are getting up and down. That's why they need to play with pace. They need to defend the three against Mizzou, because as we said, Mizzou's got to make those threes. And they've got the size, especially now with so many Mizzou players out. They have got to establish paint points and get those easy scoring options, as well as attack the offensive glass. For Mizzou, they've got to stay close. They're undermanned, undersized. They've got to stay close on the glass and get easy transition points, as we just saw.
Wow, you really know how to set up the keys. Dembele with the assist to Williams for the first points. This is going to be an interesting matchup to watch in the backcourt. Henderson and Mama have to be two of the quickest guards in the SEC.
Absolutely. Honestly, I would love just to see those two play one-on-one on each end, because they both are great defensive players, but also have the ability to take you off the bounce. I give Henderson the advantage just because of experience and probably a little bit better outside shooter, but Mama's got to stay on the floor here for Mizzou this evening, for Mizzou to have a chance.
Henderson coming off a fantastic effort last time out, 17 points, 7 assists, 7 steals against Stanford, earning SEC Co-Player of the Week award honors. So substitution for Missouri. We'll watch how it works for Mizzou. They bring in their first sub, Sarah Rose Smith. Checks in. Boston can't get it. That is Saxton fighting for the putback. South Carolina, an outstanding team on the glass, a plus 17 in rebounding margin, second only to Tennessee in the country.
Well, I've loved Victoria Saxton since she was a freshman. She is such a quick, explosive leaper. But Eric, this young lady's averaging 3 offensive rebounds a game just by pure tenacious ability to go seek the ball.
Leah Boston will check out. Leticia Mee here. Talk about versatile players. comes in for South Carolina. Started at the point for the three games that Henderson missed with an injury.
Eric, I just love him here. I just think, as you mentioned, I mean, how many times can you bring a 6'4 player off the bench and just move her to point, but can play any position offensively or defensively?
Another great job on the penetration by Mama and the kick to Hansen on the feed. And Mizzou within three. A knee here for Beal. Cook. Can't hit. That's Saxton on the inside. No. Saxton still fighting. Comes up with a great work on the glass by the senior. And another chance here for Carolina.
Eric, the only black jersey in the paint for South Carolina with four white jerseys, and Saxton still was able to get that offensive rebound.
Henderson got it. That's going to be the big challenge for Missouri. Without Asia Blackwell averaging almost 13 rebounds a game, who is going to hold their own for Mizzou on the glass? Because they're giving up a lot of size at multiple positions.
Honestly,
that's it,
Eric,
off the mark. Missouri now 2 of 8 from the floor, Christy.
I was going to say at every position they give up size. And already in this game, 4 second chance points to only 4 points total for Mizzou.
Saxton, one and done this time as Sarah Rose Smith has the rebound. Bella to Williams, backs in, no, that's a knee here, working defensively. Williams ducks under for two. Good work by the grad student, the recent graduate, just got her diploma on December 18th. And Mizzou's within three.
Well, I love the patience of LaDeja Williams on that possession. Didn't try to just go up quickly, used her body to fill the defender and created space to get the shot off.
Henderson, there's that battle against Mama, and then that's going to be a foul on Sarah Rose Smith. Well, this is a scrappy Mizzou team. So you're telling me there's a chance when it comes to Mizzou facing South Carolina. You'll see a little bit of that history next. Well, there have been some memorable matchups in Columbia, Missouri between South Carolina and Mizzou. It's a tight one in the early going here. Number one, South Carolina on top by three against shorthanded Mizzou. But think about some of that recent history. 2017, what a thriller. Sophie Cunningham had 26 points, including the game winner, to give Mizzou a 62-60 win over sixth-ranked South Carolina. Fast forward 1 year. This was very memorable. Mizzou won it 83-74. Again, Sophie Cunningham in the middle of things, celebrating as things got chippy. Dawn Staley protested a few things, was ejected from the game, and exited stage left in only a Dawn Staley way. Loved it. Just kind of drove the intensity of it. And, oh, look who's in the building here tonight, trying to give that mojo back to Mizzou. That is Sophie Cunningham, the all-time leading scorer, in town with her sister Lindsay, of course, also a former Mizzou player, so maybe trying to give a little of that magic to Mizzou tonight. They're going to need it against this number one South Carolina squad, coached by Dawn Staley. Most recently, it's been South Carolina. 2020 in Mizzou, in Columbia, Missouri, South Carolina was number one. They won it with ease in 2020. They've won four in a row in the series, 8 of the 11 meetings overall. And this is the third straight meeting when South Carolina has been ranked number one when taking on Mizzou in the fourth time, all time in this series. So in the first 7 minutes, Christy, go ahead. You want to talk history, or do you want me to fast forward a little bit?
Well, I think it's all encompassing. What I was going to say is that you have two opposing styles. You have a Mizzou team that's traditionally been a great three-point shooting team and not really had a dominant low post player, whereas with South Carolina, really quick guards who get up and down and dominant low post play. And in this game so far, it's been shocking to me just how deliberate South Carolina has been as Mizzou changes up their defense to go to a 2-3 matchup.
That's what my question was going to be. So you took care of it, partner. Just how the pace has been so far here for South Carolina on this end of the floor.
Well, and again, maybe they're trying to get the ball reversal so that the posts get more one-on-one action down low, but I've just been surprised that they haven't tried to create more off the bent, off the bounce and really get that ball inside.
Destiny Littleton is on for South Carolina. Kaya Doro has come on for Mizzou.
And Littleton's just been a zone buster for South Carolina this season. One of their best three-point shooters.
Well, another attempt from outside for South Carolina. They're cold so far from outside the three-point line. It has not been a big part of their offense, making just 5 3-pointers a game. And shooting at 33%. Camilla Cardozo comes into the game. Yes, the reserves are big, too, for South Carolina. Transfers from Syracuse in her first year with the Gamecocks.
Well, this is South Carolina in a nutshell, Eric. They were the number one team the majority of last season, and they returned everybody. Then you add the number one recruiting class and the number one transfer in Cardozo, who was the ACC Freshman of the Year and Defensive Player of the Year. So this is a team that is balanced. They are deep. They can beat you going big, going small. Players have versatility. This team has versatility.
And this team is outstanding defensively. It was a rushed off-balance shot from Troop as the shot clock was winding down. And it'll be South Carolina basketball.
And Eric, I asked Dawn Staley about her team's defense, because when you talk about Maryland, Stanford, Duke, all three are great three-point shooting teams, and her team's had success defensively. And I said, how? Why? She says, we apply great on-ball pressure. We compete. And she said, and our players are connected on the court together.
Sarah Rose Smith will check out of the game for Mizzou. Littleton, good shooter, got a good look, and drains it for three. Destiny Littleton played 18 minutes against Stanford, all in the second half, scored 6 points. She hit some key threes against UConn in that early season matchup, and that three is answered on the other end. Haley Frank.
And you just knew it was a matter of time before Frank started looking for her three-point opportunity. And after that last made three, Mizzou comes back and switches it back to the man-to-man.
Frank, 44% from outside the three-point line. That's good for second in the conference. Shot short from Bree Hall into the game for South Carolina. One and done, and with the three, Mizzou can tie it here in the final minute of the quarter. Hanson works with Frank. Hanson, good little move to get free and makes it.
Lauren Hanson's just playing at another level this season. The confidence, the maturity. Used to just be a spot-up three-point shooter. Now can beat you off the bounce as well.
Let's see how aggressive Mizzou gets here with the shot clock turned off. And now DiBella looks back to her head coach and will hold for a final shot with Mizzou down by one. Pointer is off the mark, batted out of play by Doro with 2/10 to go. And South Carolina will just get it into play. But if you're Missouri, you got to feel good about what's happened here. They started cold from the field. Shorthanded, feeling pretty good about themselves against the number one team in the country, hanging in there after the first 10 minutes playing in Como.
Well, they've got players who can knock down shots, but they also have playmakers. We've mentioned Asia Blackwell's ability to create. Well, she's not here, so that more of that falls on Mama. She's got to be able to create off the bounce and set her teammates up for those wide-open threes.
Slow start for Missouri. They were 0 for their first five from the field. They finished the quarter going 5 for 9. And, Christy, I think there's probably an adjustment that needs to be made offensively when everything, it seems, flows through Asia Blackwell. What is that adjustment like? Again, this is something 24 hours ago where Missouri found out they were going to be shorthanded and they were going to be missing their key piece on offense. That's a tough adjustment.
Well, 11 points for Mizzou, yes, is lower than their averages. And it's not just Blackwell scoring. The offense ran through her. They set so many screens to bring her to the ball, for her to flash cut and then get the pass, and then players would play off and around her. But from a rebounding perspective, I love the team part of it because they're all boxing out. And right now, their offense is starting to click on all cylinders.
Lauren Hansen knocks down the three. First lead for Mizzou, 39% from outside the three-point line on the season. That's her 25th made three, and Mizzou's up two.
It's just taken South Carolina a long time to get into a flow of a half-court offense right now. You saw Zaya Cook dribbling back and forth after that high up-ball screen. No movement behind her.
Cardozo, as Frank tried to sell the contact, no call. And it's a stop for Mizzou. And here come the Tigers. Oh, that's what Mama Gabella does so well, getting to the basket but unable to finish. Trying to answer back is Zaya Cook. It's cleaned up by Cardozo for her first points.
And Eric, sometimes that's the best offense for South Carolina. It's just getting the shot up on the glass because of how good South Carolina is on the offensive rebound, on the offensive glass. Already six in this game for South Carolina.
Here is Frank. Wasn't how she may have drawn it up, but we've seen Haley Frank score in a variety of ways in her three seasons at Mizzou.
Yeah, and I think Frank's just got to be a little less unselfish, or a little bit more selfish, I should say, in this game. With Blackwell out, more points need to come from Frank tonight.
Second on the team in scoring at 14.5 points a game. There's Dembele getting in there, and the handoff to Hansen, and two on one the other way. Cardozo with the rebound.
Hansen missed that three because she was looking over her shoulder at the much longer Amihir, who was chasing her in transition.
Amihir, good feet inside, and the easy finish for Camilla Cardozo.
And that was a post-to-post on-ball screen that was just run and executed with the roll.
Back to a wide open Frank. That's what Missouri has to have. When they get those open looks, they've got to make those threes. And Frank delivers to put the Tigers on top by three in front of a great crowd in Columbia that gets a little louder, but they quickly get quieted by Cardozo, who's doing a good job on the inside. Six quick points.
Well, there's not much Frank can do against the much taller Cardozo. She gets 2 feet that deep in the lane with her height advantage. All she has to do is turn and score.
Well, the one thing she might want to think about doing is seeing if, you know, she could put one of her teammates on her shoulders and try to defend things that way, because otherwise it's a pretty big mismatch. Hansen stepped out of bounds. Second turnover for Mizzou.
Well, and Robin Pinchton told us, we don't want to just settle for three. We need to get dribble penetration. Well, this is what dribble penetration does. It makes the defense collapse. Frank rises wide open for that three.
Frank setting the pace with 8 points after waiting patiently for what probably seemed to her like forever at the scorer's table. Aaliyah Boston is back into the game for top-ranked Carolina. She will stay out there with Cardozo, so a Twin Towers look right now for South Carolina. And one and done. Good job by Doro to get the rebound.
Sorry, you see Frank playing off of Cardozo, trying to have another body near Boston when she's down low.
Hansen got free but couldn't finish. Rebound to Boston. Littleton can't get it, and Hansen comes away. Cook is back. Hansen flips it up. No. May have been better served to kick it back out, and now South Carolina will try to get something done in transition. Instead, Cook will bring it back out. No reset.
And so you see Frank just staying in that SEC area because she will let Cardozo stay outside, dare her to shoot, because if she's away from the basket, two things. It allows Frank to double the low post and takes Cardozo off the offensive glass.
What about Missouri's job so far, Christy? Analia Boston, just two paint touches for her so far.
I think it's been great. Again, right now you have Frank who's clogging it up, but I wonder how much the early charges that Frank threw have impacted the low post plays. That time you see three people on Cardozo when she caught it.
It was like dominoes falling on top of her just to kind of muck up the works there, and it's another turnover for South Carolina.
And Eric, you see it a lot of times when teams are maybe overmatched or in this situation don't have their full squad, players rise. They play better together because they know individually they can't do it, but as a team they can.
Well, Frank is fouled attempting a three-pointer, so it'll be three free throws for Missouri. I think that was one of the things that stood out from what Robin Pinchton said. This was after shoot around today when we talked to her via Zoom. She was very optimistic. You know, in 24 hours, you don't have a chance to do a major overhaul, and you're dealing with such a great team. But play with toughness, togetherness, grittiness, be scrappy, be disruptive. They're checking some of those boxes right here, and as a result, they have a chance to extend the lead right here. So Frank shooting three. I have a chance to tell you how Christy Thomas-Scuddy is going to be spending her day tomorrow. SEC Network has Alabama and Georgia covered for the college football playoff semifinals. Coverage starts 9 a.m. Eastern, 8 a.m. Central. Wraps after the Orange Bowl with SEC football final. Break down both games, all the highlights, reactions. Nobody covers the SEC like we do, and no one will be rooting for the Crimson Tide like Christy Thomas-Scuddy will be.
Thursday's for women's basketball. Friday will be SEC football.
Nia Russell into the game for South Carolina. Henderson back on for the Gamecocks. 4-point lead for Mizzou. Henderson can't get the pull-up. There's Boston. She'll go to the free throw line. When we come back, Mizzou hanging tough with number one South Carolina. Second quarter in Como.
What's up, y'all? Nikki Fargus in studio with me, Peter Burns. Coming up at half, we'll show you a top 20 matchup between LSU and Georgia. And Shane Beamer's Gamecocks get a big win. What are you seeing right now?
Well, you're seeing a Missouri team that's playing very scrappy and playing well together. They're passing the basketball, dribble drive to the spot-up shooters. They're going to have to make some threes.
Feisty first half. We'll see you in a couple.
All right, Peter and Nikki, thanks so much. You know, you wonder, you talked about this before, Christy, about the pace for South Carolina offensively. It's been very methodical. It hasn't been this up-tempo piece. Has that done favors for Missouri to try to play to Missouri's strength right now, which is they don't have the numbers, but they're playing hard against the number one team in the country right now. And Aaliyah Boston's been shut out so far.
Well, I was going to say, you've taken one of the best players out of the country and nullified her to this point. How? It's been team defense. They have swarmed the low post every time she's gotten it. The last time Aaliyah Boston caught the ball, she was on the block and had the ability to go score, but there was no place for her to step, to do a drop step, pivot, or anything because she was so crowded. Credit Mizzou's defense to this point in the game. But, Eric, I think the other thing for Mizzou's defense is they're playing off certain players, and that's just really clogged up the paint, so players haven't been able to dribble penetrate to get good looks. They haven't been able to feed the low post. If Mizzou can kind of keep mixing up their defenses, keeping the South Carolina offense off kilter, they've got a chance tonight.
And you saw a surprising number, points in the paint, 8 for each team. You would have thought that may have been like 16-0 here at this point in the game, but it's not. It's 8-8, and Haley Frank and Lauren Hansen have teamed up to be a 1-2 punch in the absence of Asia Blackwell. They contribute a lot when Blackwell's on the floor as well. Frank at better than 14 points a game. Hansen third in scoring at 10.5 points a game. That's a jump from last year when she had 6.5 points a game. And again, three-point shooting is going to be key. Mizzou is 3-for-6 from outside the three-point line. And if you want to factor in the fact that Frank was fouled shooting a three and made three free throws, well, there's a fourth three-pointer for Mizzou, which is halfway to their season average and something they have to hit here tonight. So Boston at the free throw line has her first point. Settles for one.
And And Eric, you mentioned the point production of Hanson and Frank, but I also want to make sure that we're giving credit where credit's due, and that's to Mama, and that is to Haley Troop. Their ability right now to get by their defender off the bounce has forced rotations, which has left Hanson and Frank open for some of those outside shots.
They also each have two assists so far. Shot clock is down to four, down to three. Troop's going to have to heave it, but doesn't heave it in time. And it's a stop for South Carolina defensively. South Carolina holding opponents to 33% shooting from the field. And as we talked about at the top of the show, half of their opponents so far have been ranked in the top 15 nationally.
Well, this is definitely a well-tested South Carolina team. I think right now for them, it's that pace piece of it. They got to start getting out in transition. But you can't get out in transition unless you get stops. And Mizzou has done a good job, relatively speaking, of taking care of the ball so far in this game with only three turnovers.
Williams tries to post up on Saxton. The Deja Williams and one.
Deja Williams, undersized, but does such a great job of feeling defenders to create space. Has a long step to get by Saxton there. Draws the foul. Great touch at the rim.
Williams going to have to play a lot here tonight, and she has not played a lot. She had a procedure. They clean up a knee problem in April. She's averaged 15 minutes a game. She's been coming off the bench. She's already played 11 minutes tonight, so they're going to have to milk some minutes out of the grad student here tonight. Missouri by six.
Eric, as a competitor, these are the games you just live for. Number one team in the country on your floor. No one thinks you have a chance except everybody within the white uniform. So I have a feeling that Deja Williams is going to just beg, plead, and just give Robin Pinchon every chance to keep her on the floor tonight.
South Carolina settles for a three, and a foul is called. If it's Boston, it's her second. It's on Boston, it's her second. South Carolina was up by six early, 12-6. Missouri's outscored Dawn Staley's team 19-7 since that time to go up by six, and Boston goes to the bench with 3:19 to go in the half.
Eric, when I was a coach, and you game plan for great players, as I'm sure South Carolina had done for Blackwell, and then they don't show up to play because of injury or whatever, I was always nervous as a coach because you don't know how that affects your team. Do they lose a little bit of that focus, just that killer tenacity that they've been playing with for the better part of this season as Williams continues to go to work down low?
Missouri on top by eight. Boston on the bench with two fouls. Cardozo's given good production off the bench so far, and they send it over to Anaya Russell, who knocks down the three. Did not play against Stanford, averaging just over 2 points a game. Russell comes through with the three to bring Carolina within five.
There's so much depth on the South Carolina team, and I love the fact that Russell didn't play but has her opportunity now and is ready to perform. And credit Cardozo for not forcing a shot up against that triple team to find her open teammate.
Amihir can't score on the inside. One and done. Williams is just unloading the bag of tricks right now. 11 points. 5 of 7 from the field.
And Eric, you mentioned it. Deja Williams started her career as a Gamecock, transferred here to Mizzou, so you got to believe this game means just a little bit more to the graduate player.
She has scored 7 points in this quarter. She has scored the last 7 points for Mizzou. Good drive to the basket. Bree Beal hit that early three. Her second field goal now with five.
And I love the change of pace by Bree Beal. Four white players in the lane defensively. As soon as she hesitated, they started to go back to their own players, opened up the lane to go score.
Frank trying to show up that range, and she buries the three. Big crowd at Mizzou Arena getting to their feet. Final minute, first half. That was almost the relative of the heat check for LaDeja Williams. If she was going to put it on the floor and drive to the basket, I think Robin Pinchton was probably the loudest person in the building at that point saying, give it to Mama, who has it right now, guarded by Henderson.
Well, I was going to say, I think Coach Pinchton got the assist there, telling her post player, no.
Hanson can't get it. Williams fighting on the glass and knocked it away, and Mizzou's got it. Williams couldn't spin it up, plenty of time here for South Carolina. Henderson wasting no time. Spun out. Cardozo, not the first time, but the second time. Troop with a heave. But this crowd will tell you what happened in the first half for Mizzou against the number one team in the country. Great quarter for Williams and for the Tigers. Missouri's on top by six at halftime. Peter and Nikki, all yours. For the third time this season, South Carolina trails at halftime. On the road in their SEC opener, the number one Gamecocks are down to Mizzou 32-26 as we're ready to start the third quarter. Eric Free, Christy Thomas-Scuddy back with you. Haley Frank was a key piece, as she usually is, in the first half for Mizzou.
Absolutely. 3 of 4 from three. She played off her teammates' dribble penetration, read the defense well. But, Eric, we said, who's going to step up for Mizzou? And it has been LaDeja Williams. Best half of the year for this young lady. She's been patient in the low post. She's picked her spots. She's used her long legs to step by defenders to score at the rim.
Take a look at some of the key numbers in the first half. Three-pointers, Missouri knocked down four. Aaliyah Boston held in check. 1 point, three rebounds, picked up her second foul with 3:19 to go in the second quarter. 25 points combined for Williams and Frank. Just to clarify, they have trailed previously three times at halftime, won all three of those games. So this is the fourth time this year that South Carolina has been down at halftime. What should we expect differently here in the second half? And as I say that, I think was going to be your answer. Get Aaliyah Boston involved.
I was going to say that. Your All-American needs to get touches in the paint, and she's just got to be more deliberate at getting to the rim. Credit Mizzou's defense. They suffocated the low post players down low for South Carolina, but there, gave her space to work, was able to finish.
And she comes in and rips down the rebound off the DeBellamis. Henderson. Zaya Cook hesitated the first time, but off the miss. It's Aaliyah Boston and the foul.
Eric, you're never up for player of the year without a competitive nature. And you're seeing this from the get-go in this half. Aaliyah Boston off the bounce, creates space for her shot, and then just pursues the miss to draw the foul for the and-one.
And then tipped off of Bree Beal into the hands of Boston. Another chance here for South Carolina.
Eric, every coach will tell you the first 2 minutes of each quarter are the most important. And so far, it's been all South Carolina. Mizzou needed to get that stop.
Zaya Cook is just cold right now. She's been struggling over the last couple of weeks. Another miss there. And here comes Mizzou. Lead is down to two. Troop tried to force it into Hanson. And a tie-up. Possession arrow will keep it with Mizzou. One of the stats from the first half that jumped out to Christy was Missouri had 7 assists. Dembella had 3, no turnovers. Troop had 3 assists, no turnovers. That had to have been a vital piece for Robin Pinchton and her team to stay in this game against number one South Carolina.
Absolutely, twofold. You're a great shooting team. So how do you make buckets? You got to have the opportunity to shoot by not turning it over, but also take care of the ball so you're not giving South Carolina the opportunity to get out and run in transition. That was huge that South Carolina had 0 points off of Mizzou's turnovers in the first half.
Officials are having a conversation right now. Eric Bruton, Keisha Thompson, Safe Esho. Shot clock right now is at 30. Eric Bruin is passing along the information to clock operator scores table, and they are calling for a reset here. So it will be Missouri basketball on the baseline. Don Staley wanted a little bit of an explanation as well. Troop Williams. Can she do her work against Boston? In and out. Now off the miss, you can see a little bit of a push from South Carolina. Good recovery by Mizzou. And good help by Haley Frank diving out of play. It will be South Carolina basketball as Frank went off the court.
Well, Frank's just been that help side defender all game. There, nearly gets the steal. You have to love the effort by Haley Frank to try to keep the ball alive for her team.
Boston wide open look. Won't go, but that's going to be Frank getting called for the foul as she was boxing Sexton. That's two on Frank. Fouls will be a key issue here for Missouri. They played seven in the first half. They've dressed eight here tonight. Again, if you're just joining us, playing without Asia Blackwell, averaging a double-double on the season. Boston went down to keep it alive. Henderson. Rebound to Hanson.
And Eric, that
Hanson
time
had 7 points in the first half.
Sorry, I was going to say on the out-of-bounds defense, Mizzou mixed it up again, that time going 2-3 zone. And South Carolina's just not been able to knock down the open shot yet consistently.
Mizzou looking for their first points of the third quarter. Led by six at halftime. Taken away by Boston. Turnover Missouri, two on one the other way. Cook. Oh, nothing is dropping right now for Saya Cook. Henderson fouled on the follow-up. And a timeout being called by Missouri here in the early going in the third quarter. We'll take it as well. Two-point game in Columbia. Well, Carolina fans making the trip out to Mizzou to watch the number one team in the country in a tight one against Missouri to open SEC play. But this is a South Carolina team that took on all comers in non-conference play. Six games against ranked teams, two of those games against a team that was number two in the country. It started with a win over NC State in Raleigh, 66-57 the final, knocking off number five NC State. Then down in the Bahamas against Oregon. Amihir in South Carolina with a 17-point win. They followed that up with a victory against Connecticut. Destiny Littleton had a good game. Zaya Cook came through in the clutch, and Carolina pulled away from UConn. Then back stateside, a win over Maryland by seven, 66-59 the final, taking down a top 10 team. And we saw the last timeout for South Carolina where they knocked off Stanford, fell behind by 18 at Colonial Life Arena. Got it done against Stanford, 65-61. The final, their last three games against ranked opponents. Their average margin of victory, 7 points in those games, all single-digit wins. So a tight game is nothing new for Dawn Staley's team, and they're in a tight one here on the road to open SEC play.
Well, one thing that I love about this non-conference schedule for South Carolina is, yes, they've won every time they've been tested, but it was the varying styles of play that I thought was really interesting. And Dawn felt like her team was ready for Mizzou because they played a South Dakota team second game of the season. And so nothing is new that South Carolina is seeing. I think it's just the little things that they've got to tighten up on. And I'm eager to see Zaya Cook, how she continues to respond. I'd love to see her create off the bounce, create some kind of easy scoring opportunity, get herself going offensively.
Frank trying to get around Sexton. And then count it. and the foul on Saxton. Haley Frank stuck with it and has a chance for a three-point play.
Early in Haley Frank's career, she was pretty much a spot-up three shooter. Now the ability to create off that bounce, get Saxton in the air, then uses her own strength to go through the contact to finish.
That is the third personal foul on one of the starters for South Carolina, Victoria Saxton, so she'll head to the bench. Cardoso, who played very well in the first half, 8.6 rebounds, comes in. Frank finishes the three-point play. She's got 17 points to pace Mizzou. What'd you think about that Robin Pinchton timeout very early here in this quarter before the Henderson free throws, Christy?
Well, I love it. Again, we've talked about it. They don't have Asia Blackwell. And I thought offensively to begin has the offense usually flows through Blackwell. But she's not here today. They struggled to start the quarter. Head coach calls the timeout to get her team settled down.
Aaliyah Boston is here. Took a little while for the check-in, but she's here tonight. 6 points in the second half for Boston. Carolina back within two. Oh, nice little hesitation by Haley Troop to get her first points.
Troop's another young lady who just really elevated her game this season. I think her change of pace has improved so much. Has always had great basketball IQ. Well, now she's not pre-programming the balls in her hands. She's doing a great job of reading the defense, as we just saw, to finish at the rim.
Boston, high-low to Cardozo.
You mean high-to-high.
High to higher.
Yes.
Four minutes played, second half. Yeah, it's going to be a traveling violation as Troop dragged the foot. Turnover for Missouri. They've done a good job taking care of the basketball. Dembele tried to tiptoe on the sideline. Couldn't get it done. I really think she's played well. You can tell she was up to the challenge tonight going up against Destiny Henderson. That's been a great one to watch off the ball or on the ball between the two. Very quick player, outstanding on-ball defender, the sophomore from Spain.
Absolutely, Eric. And I think so many times we focus on points, but what Dembele's doing to help her team without shooting has been remarkable. As you mentioned, great defense. But she's taken care of the ball. She's gotten her team in an offense, and she's created off the bounce to set her shooters up.
Cook knocks down the three.
That's what I said, right? Cook just needed to spot up for three. No easy look. Just knocked down a three.
Well, she's not going to turn it down. Zaya Cook open. She's not going to turn it down. She was 1-for-9 against Stanford. Christy just talked about it a couple of moments ago, trying to find her shot. She's struggled tonight, but that puts South Carolina in front by one. Hanson looking for her first points in the second half. Gets it on the drive.
And this is where Mizzou's ability to spread the floor is why the guards are getting to the rim. They're bringing Cardozo away with some screening action by her player, and the guards have turned the corner.
Henderson can't score. Rebound by Sarah Rose Smith. Frank for Hanson. Henderson, right up on Mama, and she ties her up. There's that matchup right there. Henderson wins that one-on-one battle. It'll be South Carolina basketball when we come back. One-point game, third quarter in Columbia. South Carolina was down by 6 at halftime, 32-26. Aaliyah Boston, the All-American, struggled in the first half, 0-for-2 from the field. Had 3 rebounds, 2 fouls, sat for the final 3:19, was ready to go once the bell rang for the third quarter, Christy.
Well, Don Staley has told us, I don't even have to say anything to Aaliyah Boston. because her ability to dominate has been on full display here in the third quarter. Hasn't forced the action. Just taken what the defense has given her. You play off, she drives by. If you crowd her, she's going to power it up with that strength. It has been all Leah Boston for South Carolina here in the third.
And again, the paint touches were limited in the first half. She had three paint touches total in the first half. She's already had three in the second half. It's made a big difference. 7 points so far for Boston. Cardozo leading the way with 10 for South Carolina. On the other side, it was the grit, it was the fire, the determination for Missouri. They had that 8-0 run in the first half. They led by six at halftime. They got to recapture that a little bit. They still have the 1-point lead. We do know that they have a big fan watching on the SEC Network. Asia Blackwell, hello. Wish we were watching you play here tonight. Hope to see you on the court soon. But she's handling the marketing and promotions for us right now. Turn on the SEC Network right now. Yes, we are watching number one at South Carolina in a tight one, playing without Asia here in the third quarter. LaDeja Williams, 11 points in the first half. That was a big part of the success for Missouri. The Mama Destiny matchup back on after Henderson got the tie-up. Possession arrow gave it to South Carolina. Cardozo, Boston. No. Cardozo, yes.
Eric, that possession's why I say sometimes even a bad shot is great offense for South Carolina because of their ability to clean up the glass. Already in the game now, 14 offensive rebounds that they've been able to convert into 14 second chance points.
They are plus 10 in rebounding margin. That won't drop. Ben Beal has another rebound off the DeBellamis. There's Mom in the backcourt. Henderson gets it across. Another touch for Boston. Another try from Cook that won't drop. Then Beal gets called for the reach-in. A reminder, coming up, men's basketball doubleheader on the SEC Network in the new year. It's on Tuesday. 11th-ranked Auburn will take on South Carolina. That will be in Columbia, 6:30 Eastern Time, 5:30 Central. Then it'll be Arkansas in Fayetteville taking on Vanderbilt. Both games also available on the ESPN app. Of course, that's just one app, one tap. Mizzou Arena in Columbia, the SEC opener, one of three games of the seven that were originally on the schedule being played tonight, four canceled due to COVID protocols, postponed, I should say. This game is on. Missouri shorthanded, dressing eight without their leading scorer and rebounder, Asia Blackwell. But they have battled here against number one South Carolina, fighting on the inside with the shot clock down to two, and a foul is called on Cardozo with the shot clock at one. And freshman Kaya Doro will go to the free throw line.
And Kaya Doro deserves that because on the previous defensive play, she boxed out Cardozo to make sure she didn't get the offensive rebound putback. This time on her own offensive glass, grabs that rebound, probably a little fortuitous with that whistle.
Foul is on Boston, Christy. So that's three on Aaliyah Boston. Boston heads to the bench with three. Freshman from Tucson, playing 9 minutes a game on average in the first 13 games of the season. Missouri 11-2. This is a Mizzou team that gave Baylor all they could handle in Waco, almost pulled that out. Their other loss was at Missouri State, but 11 wins on the season. They won nine last year. They did lose six that were canceled because of COVID-19 and also weather issues. This is a good Missouri team. They've proven it so far here tonight, taking on number one South Carolina, and it'll be Mizzou basketball with 2:42 to go in the third quarter.
And Robin Pinchton said this team came into the season with a chip on their shoulder. They had six losses by a single possession a year ago, and that they wanted to get better, really focused on their defense in the offseason because they were third in scoring a year ago, but 10th in their defense. Already today, we're seeing the improvement from a defensive perspective.
Saxton back on the floor for South Carolina, playing with three fouls. Troop Frank. Nowhere for her to go. Dembella from the outside. That won't drop, and Cardozo has her eighth rebound.
Well, that possession from Mizzou, the spacing just wasn't good, so there was no true alleys to turn the corner and get to the rim off dribble penetration.
Pull up is short, the rebound for Frank. But now 2 for 11 from the field. Mizzou's last game, they won at Illinois last Wednesday, 84-65. They fell behind in that game 13-1, ended up with five and double figures in the bragging rights win. Shot 51% from the field. This is a team that came in first in the SEC, sixth in Division I in shooting at nearly 48%. They've been in that area code today at 44% from outside the three-point line and 42% overall.
And if you're South Carolina, at some point you got to make a run, because I think letting this scrappy, gritty Mizzou team stay close is really dangerous down the stretch. You mentioned it. I really believe if Asia Blackwell doesn't foul out against Baylor, they probably get that W. They just didn't shoot the ball well against a really talented Missouri State team on the road. But this team could easily only have one loss on the season to this point.
I'm here in the game for South Carolina. Williams, five on the shot clock. And Cardozo gets called for the foul. She shows her frustration. That's her second.
Well, we talked to Robin Pinchin about the offensive game plan. She said, we're not going to live and die by the three. We've got to get paint touches. We've got to create at the rim. And we're seeing that. And it's been by both the guards and the bigs for Mizzou. This last time by LaDeja Williams.
One of two for Williams. First point of the second half. Now with 12, came in averaging 8 points a game. Back-to-back good scoring games for Williams. Had 13 in the win against Illinois. That came in 16 minutes off the bench. Got the start tonight with Blackwell out. Cook tries again and drains the three. South Carolina in front by one. Troop trying to work with Williams. Williams on the cut, but it was last touched by Henderson. Eight to shoot with 37 to go in the quarter.
And Eric, I'm starting to see maybe a little fatigue from Mizzou. Like, that was a quick hitter, that there was nothing quick. Players weren't getting to their spots and coming off of screens. And that's what they were doing so well in the first half. That created open spaces, open shots, open lanes to create dribble penetration.
Williams checks out, and Hansen is fouled attempting a three. That's the second time tonight that South Carolina has fouled a three-point shooter. Foul on Beal. That's her second. And Hansen will step to the free throw line. 71% free throw shooter. And one thing we've seen from Robin Pinchton's teams through the years, you don't want to get into a free throw shooting contest or any shooting contest with them, because they do well at the line. I also would not have expected tonight, Christy, knowing about the personnel and trying to guess the game plan, that the free throw shooting would be such a big difference in this game. Missouri's 11 of 12. South Carolina's attempted just 5 free throws, 3 here in this quarter. Cook, no. Ami here. Plenty of time here for a second chance for South Carolina. Henderson. Henderson with three, with two, and draws the foul and will head to the free throw line. Frank gets whistled for her third personal.
We've talked about the second chance opportunities, but this is a big one. Frank is still moving. Good call by the official.
So Frank will check out. Williams will come in. One more to come for Henderson. After a slow start to this quarter, Missouri pushed back, but South Carolina with a chance to tie it up. Henderson does just that. Missouri looking for something big here, and they get it from Hanson, but she walked. The question is, will they put any time on the clock? I think the officials say no, that's it for the quarter. And we are tied at 45 heading to the fourth, Christy.
Third quarter belonged to Aaliyah Boston. Off the bounce, off the glass. Haley Frank, though, continued her scoring ways for Mizzou. We got a good one coming up to the fourth.
SEC women's basketball. Missouri and number one South Carolina, even at 45 as we are ready to head to the fourth quarter. Missouri led at half by six. South Carolina came out a little determined to get it into the hands of Aaliyah Boston in the third quarter, get it into the paint, Christy Thomas-Scuddy, but the paint points are still pretty tight in this game.
It is remarkable because South Carolina came into the night averaging 37 points a game in the paint, and they have such a huge height advantage that you would think that they'd be able to really exploit that against this Mizzou team. But Mizzou's defense has been so good around the basket, and credit them, as many offensive rebounds that South Carolina has, Mizzou's also prevented that many by just simply boxing out, staying strong down low.
Robin Pinchton said about this game tonight, after they found out yesterday they were going to be able to dress just eight, the eight players we do have, they're fully engaged. They haven't wavered. They understand the challenge. They're looking forward to taking on the number one team in the country. She was proud to how they responded in practice and in shoot around today. She's got to be doubly proud after what they've done so far. Tied at 45 in the fourth quarter in the SEC opener. Boston back out there for South Carolina with the three fouls. Hanson, tough take for two. Anderson runs out of room, finds Cook. Cook finds an opening, that won't drop, and then Cook gets called for the foul.
Eric, so many times you'll hear the term speed kills. Well, I got news for you. Change of pace is just as effective, and that's what Lauren Hanson has improved so much this season. Knows that all she has to do is get her feet, defender's feet to go dead, does that with a change of pace, and gets to the rim.
South Carolina comes away with it. Henderson for Cook. Cook uses the Boston screen. Boston hits the glass. Dembele gets on the floor. Tie up, possession arrow will keep it with South Carolina. Now, we talked about Robin Pinchon saying the eight players she had. Well, she did correct that later. She said seven and a half players because LaDeja Williams is not at 100% yet. She's been coming back from that knee problem. She is battling with Aaliyah Boston. You wonder, as we get deeper into the fourth quarter, how much Williams will have in the tank going up against the All-American.
Well, I think at this point, it's a matter of want to. And this is what's so great about conference play. You're seeing it. Throw out the records. You throw out the stats. It's just about who wants it more to this point with a quarter to go in this game so tight.
Williams has already played a season-high 26 minutes tonight. Again, came in averaging 15 minutes a game. She's got it up top against Boston. Dembella, open three. Missouri gets another three. First points for the sophomore. Mizzou's up five. Haley Troop gets whistled for the foul.
Well, I love that play call. You got two bigs in, but you sent Bree Bill down to the block to post up. Troop got caught behind, got called for the foul trying to come around.
Boston on the drive. What's the call? That's going to be a call against Missouri. Looked for a split second like maybe it was going to be called an offensive foul. I think Aaliyah Boston is still looking to see, hang on a second, am I at the free throw line? You can hear the crowd now reacting. That move right there. Oh, yeah, well, there's the two fingers for the hoop, but you can hear the crowd's reaction because they thought that should have been an offensive foul. Troop taking the contact. And Missouri thought they had that call. You could see the players coming to celebrate with Troop.
Well, it was really Eric Bruton's mechanics there because he drops the arm forward as though
that's
it was a charge
saw, yes.
call, but then put the two fingers out.
Three-point play for Aaliyah Boston. Into double figures with 10. A rebound away from her sixth straight double-double.
Great job of icing that on-ball screen by South Carolina. Just blew up the play.
And now Missouri's going to call a timeout. Shot clock down to 7. Not much happening there. And Robin Pinchton's going to take part of this timeout to express her considerable displeasure with the previous call. 2-point game in the fourth. It's been a good one. In Columbia, Missouri, the SEC opener between Mizzou and the number one team of the country, undefeated South Carolina, with Mizzou hanging on to a 2-point lead here in the fourth quarter. Eric Free, Christy Thomas-Scuddy back here with you. Again, we've talked about it. Missouri shorthanded, dressing 8 without their leading scorer and rebounder, Asia Blackwell, tonight, health and safety protocols. But this Missouri team has rallied around one another, and they are giving number one South Carolina a true fight tonight.
Well, they're feeding off their head coach's passion. You saw that as we went to break with Robin Pinchton. But you're also seeing a really well-connected team that plays for and with one another so well. My biggest question is, do they have enough in the tank to finish this out?
I got another question for you. What's at stake here as we play in the fourth quarter? South Carolina trying to stay undefeated. Their last regular season loss to an unranked team in the SEC was in Columbia, Missouri, against Missouri. We showed you those back-to-back wins in 2017 and 2018. There is a rivalry here. It's cooled off a little bit in the last couple of years. And Missouri against number one teams, they've never won as they take on the number one team tonight. If they got this win here tonight, how unlikely would that be? Finding out 24 hours ago they were going to be without 5 players, including their leading scorer and rebounder. But again, everyone has had a hand in it here tonight. Haley Frank with 17 points, Hanson with 14, Williams in a star turn with 12 points and 9 rebounds. Dembella just hit that big three a moment ago. Doro off the bench knocked down a couple of free throws. Who's it going to be here down the stretch, and what will South Carolina do in response here against Missouri? Now the timeout. Missouri draws up a play for Hanson for a wide open three, and Mizzou is back up by 5. South Carolina wasting no time to to get a couple back. Saxton. Gambella, can she do it again? Yes! Saxton, beautiful dish to Boston for two.
We talk about Mizzou being so connected, but let's not forget the experience factor for South Carolina, just on full display with that last possession. Saxton doesn't force it, hits her post side or weak side post buddy for the easy two.
Hansen trying to work against Boston, and Boston gets whistled for her fourth personal foul.
Eric, credit Hansen. Hansen realized she had to switch a Boston, so didn't try to settle for the three and took it to the rim. But great execution out of the timeout by Mizzou. Dribble penetration one side, flare screen on the backside for Hansen, and then Mama spots up for three.
So Boston heads to the bench with four personal fouls, just under 6 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Gambella on the drive. Beal backs in Frank. Frank can't fight off the strong Bree Beal. First points of the second half for Beal. Back to a four-point game.
An interesting lineup for South Carolina now. They go small by South Carolina standards. Beal now playing more of a four position.
Mama is stepping up when the spotlight is bright. Travel. Sophie Cunningham leading the cheers with her sister Lindsay in front of a big crowd at Mizzou Arena. Tigers with a 6-point lead and possession inside of five to play in the fourth quarter. Knocked out of the hands of Troop, still Missouri ball.
When Eric, you're seeing Robin Pinchton call every offensive set right now, putting players where she wants them for their execution.
Oh, beautiful little look away, but it won't drop for Mama, and here comes South Carolina trying to push the other way. And knocked out of bounds. It's a good play there by Troop because Littleton was wide open in the corner. Very good three-point shooter. A reminder, SEC Network has Bama and Georgia covered tomorrow for the college football playoff semifinals. Coverage starts at 9 Eastern time and will wrap up after the Orange Bowl with SEC football final. They'll have all the breakdowns, highlights, reaction. They've got you covered because nobody covers the SEC like we do. Aaliyah Boston back into the game. 4:18 to go. She checked out with 6:02 to go. Cardozo out to Littleton, who got that look for three, but it won't drop. Hansen can't hit the three. Henderson into Cardozo, got in deep and finished. Good game for Cardozo. She's got 14. That's a South Carolina high for her.
And that's tough for Williams. She already gives up about 4 inches to Cardozo, but when she gets that deep, play is done for the post player for South Carolina.
Three, 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 Cook making it tough on Hanson. Hanson couldn't get it, and Cardozo touched it last, or what's the call here? They're saying it's Missouri basketball. Well, Williams had a pretty good swipe at that, but it will be Mizzou basketball.
And it's key now for Mizzou. If they're able to get to the rim off dribble penetration, they've got to finish. Already two missed layups in this quarter alone.
Troop takes a look at the shot clock. It's now down to six. Frank calls for it for two. points for Haley Frank. Back to a six-point lead. Henderson, mid-range, is short. Won't miss twice, though. And a timeout call by South Carolina. So a timeout called by Dawn Staley. 62-58 Mizzou. Haley Frank, 6 of 7 from the field. As a team, Missouri doing what they need to, Christy Thomas-Scuddy, shooting 46% from the field, which is just below their season average, but 50% from the three-point line. They needed to make shots tonight against number one South Carolina, and they have done that to this point.
And they've taken care of the basketball. Right now, if I'm Robin Pinchton, I'm saying to my team, we don't need one shot. We need to make sure that we're taking care of the ball to get that shot. I thought Lauren Hanson has rushed a couple of shots here down the stretch. Take the best shot possible. And if your mama, take care of the ball. I expect Destiny Henderson to really get up in him, in her now in the half-court defense and try to force a turnover.
Six turnovers for each team. To your point, Christy, of Missouri taking care of the basketball. Leah Boston on the floor, playing with four personal fouls. South Carolina brings the pressure. Missouri breaks it. Troop trying to get it into Williams, but Bree Beal, great defensive player, makes a great defensive play. And South Carolina scores on the other end, and one chance for a three-point play, but it starts with a defense by Bree Beal.
And it seemed like by extending the full court pressure, it just sped South Carolina up. Troop kills her dribble, tries to force an entry pass. Beal with the steal. Zaya Cook stepping up with a big 2-1 now at the free throw line.
Cook into double figures now with 10 points. Holds there. The lead is down to two. Troop. Hanson, little off balance, couldn't get it to go, and here comes Henderson, 3-on-2 for South Carolina. Henderson gave it up to Amir.
That was a great no call by the official. Mizzou ran the exact same play that they ran out of the timeout earlier for Hanson to get the three. This time couldn't knock it down, and South Carolina just outrun him.
6-0 run for South Carolina to tie it up at 62, less than 90 seconds to go in the fourth. Hanson's going to come up short. Boston's got it, and here's Henderson. Amir stolen by Troop. Great defensive play by Troop, who will try to cash in on the other end at the free throw line.
Eric, we've got two teams with a lot of experience, none more so than Haley True, who shoots the gap there, gets the steal, and then uses her body so well against the much taller Bree Beal to draw that contact and get to the free throw line.
True slow to get up. She will limp to the free throw line. Just a big crowd at Mizzou Arena tonight, and they have been rewarded with a great performance from their Tigers as Haley Troop goes to the free throw line. 67% free throw shooter. Missouri by one with 1 minute to go. Anderson off balance. No. Williams rips down the rebound for Missouri. And DeBella is fouled by Bree Beal with 40.8 to go.
That's the person you want to foul.
Fourth foul on South Carolina.
Well, I was going to say, you want to foul Mama DeBelle because she's only shooting 50% on the season. But more importantly, South Carolina is just trying to get up to where they can put Mizzou in the bonus if they need to.
Next foul will do it. Fourth foul on Beal. No need to foul here for South Carolina. Play good defense. Shot clock's now down to 15. DeBelle. Henderson, did she tie her up again, or did she foul her? I think the foul was called.
I was sitting in my seat cringing as DeBella was just kind of fumbling with the ball. That looked clean.
Henderson.
Again, I'm getting a backside. That looked clean.
Yeah, Henderson tied her up on a very similar play in the same spot on the floor earlier in the game. It was called a tie-up, but this is called a foul on Henderson. Her first. It is the fifth team foul on South Carolina. So two free throws for someone, as Christy mentioned, 50%, 6 of 12 from the free throw line. And you can see just putting her hands on her head right away. No problem that time. Timeout call by South Carolina. Nail biting time in Columbia. Missouri's on top 64-62 with a timeout. Sophie Cunningham has been celebrating with everybody tonight. SEC Now crew getting ready to go. After the game, they'll have a recap of this game, opening night in SEC Women's Hoop, preview of tomorrow's college football playoffs, all coming up on SEC Now. Well, you saw Sophie Cunningham. You remember this rivalry between Missouri and South Carolina has had some tight games, has had Missouri wins. Can they do it here again with her in the stands watching instead of leading Missouri to wins against South Carolina in 2017 and 2018?
Well, here's the biggest defensive stand for Mizzou in this early part of the season. If I'm South Carolina, first and foremost, get the ball inbounded. And they've been so good on out-of-bounds plays this season. But if you're Mizzou, it's not the first shot that will hurt you. It is that second and third shot opportunity by South Carolina that you need to be worried about.
They go right to Saxton, who finds Boston. No. Boston's not done yet and gets it to go to tie it at 64. Timeout called by Mizzou. You are not going to keep Aaliyah Boston down for long. Another double-double. That's her sixth straight.
Eric, I was going to say, I love the play call because you know that Mizzou's going to double the low post. And so once Saxton got it, she kicks it to Boston. But as I said, it's not the first shot. For Boston, she stayed with it, got the putback, and scored. Mizzou immediately calls timeout. I'm assuming they're advancing the ball to the other end of the court. And so I'll say this again for Mizzou. They've got to get the ball inbounded cleanly. I wouldn't be surprised if we see some weak side screening action now by Mizzou to try to get some open looks.
So the game reset just to clear up the timeout. South Carolina with two timeouts remaining. And Missouri, as you can see, next to their record, down with one timeout. So they do have a timeout remaining if they have trouble getting the basketball in now, Christy. But if they get it in, when they get it in, what's the play? Who do you draw it up for here?
I'm going, what they've had a lot of success is on-ball screen with a rise by Frank on the weak side. So you've got a guard getting downhill trying to get to the rim, and then you've got an outlet, both ball side, weak side, and behind you to kick to if you're cut off.
What a great start to conference play in the SEC. Number one South Carolina, 12-0. Unranked Missouri at 11-2. Mizzou has been in it throughout. A chance here with 21.2 to go. Trouble getting it into Troop, and she touched it last. They will go to the monitor to review it. The call on the floor is that it was last touched by Missouri, and it'll be South Carolina basketball. The concern would be, what camera angles will you have with the back to our main cameras here? And they'll go to the monitor.
The call on the floor right now is Black's ball. We're reviewing that right now for the out of bounds.
Will they be able to see something? Well, this will be a pretty good view right here. Who touches it last? Is it Troop? That's off Troop's right knee. Did anybody touch it afterward? It did not look that way.
And Eric, I have to say, Mizzou got away with the travel there. Frank traveled before she even got rid of the ball.
While she was out of bounds.
Yes.
That looks like the call on the court will be confirmed that it went off the right knee of Haley Troop. I didn't see anybody touch it after that fact, before it went out of bounds. So this should be South Carolina basketball with the shot clock off and 20 seconds to go.
Well, I think the ball is going to go through Aaliyah Boston here, either as a passer or to look to score. And I said it before with the last time they had the ball out, but Mizzou has to keep South Carolina off the glass here and limit them to one shot.
Still looking at the monitor. We'll take one more look. That's the knee of Troop. And I don't see anybody touching this. Troop was the closest one to it. Saxton was in there for South Carolina. Well, Missouri has one foul to give. They're still at the monitor. The look that you saw is the look that the officials have at the monitor. So they have access to what our cameras have shot and what has been recorded. They have those looks in playback. But they're still at the monitor. Here's the announcement.
After review, the call stands. It is Black's ball. Game clock will be reset to 20.9.
So a little delay at the monitor just to get the clock right, it would appear. So 9/10 on the clock. South Carolina basketball and a chance to win. Key point two, if South Carolina decides to go early maybe here, Christy, and the work on the glass that Aaliyah Boston does so well. Missouri does have one timeout left. So if South Carolina scores or Mizzou gets a rebound and there's enough time left, they call that timeout, advance the basketball into the front court.
Yeah, and I don't believe Dawn Staley called a timeout, unless I'm mistaken.
No, I don't think so. I think it was just a video review. Yeah.
Right. So they still got the two.
Two timeouts for South Carolina, one for Missouri confirmed. Here we go. Can number one South Carolina pull it off at Mizzou? Henderson with six, with five. Henderson's in trouble. Cook on the run, off the rim, will go to overtime. South Carolina had a chance to win it in regulation. They'll have 5 minutes more to work in Columbia. Mizzou and South Carolina, OT in the SEC opener when we come back. Number one, South Carolina being taken to overtime by the Missouri Tigers in the SEC opener for the two teams, 64-64 at the end of regulation. Here's the final possession for South Carolina.
Well, great job by Haley Frank there, just to come off slightly to prevent Destiny Henderson from turning the corner, and then just a bailout kick, and Zia Cook couldn't get the shot to fall.
Each team heading to overtime for the first time this season. The fouls, worth reminding, Boston with four, Beal with four. As we head to OT, no one with more than three for Missouri. Frank with the three personal fouls. They've done a good job of staying foul-free, being shorthanded here tonight. On to OT. South Carolina wins the tip. Boston can't get it. Rebound for Mizzou. Leah Boston now 6 of 12 from the field. 14 points. Had 1 point in the first half. She does have a double-double. 14 points. Now 11 rebounds. Boston's got good range, but on the second look, she'll show you that range and knock down the three.
I think my partner Eric Freed gets the assist with that one. She heard you. But honestly, this has been the game plan of Mizzou. They've been backing off the other post to jam things up down low. That time, Aaliyah Boston makes them pay.
16 points since halftime for Aaliyah Boston. Williams tries to work on Beal. No one down there to help out. And here comes South Carolina. Little spring in their step right now with Saxton scores.
I'd love to see Haley Frank get a touch here.
Here is Frank. Hanson. Hanson takes it at Saxton. That ends a 7-0 run for South Carolina. Much needed hoop for Mizzou.
So you see Frank just sitting on top of the other post player, just trying to jam things up as Saxton is her matchup.
Knocked away by Dembele. Takes off the other way. Rebound to Boston. Henderson. From her knees, got the rebound and tried to get the assist, but it's taken away by Mizzou. Williams played 37 minutes tonight. Trying to find a little bit more strength against Aaliyah Boston, who knocks it away.
You're just starting to see a little bit of that fatigue from Mizzou. A lot of standing around, trying to go one-on-one versus the way they've executed the majority of this game has been with one another, through one another.
Henderson. Cook is open. Sexton with the offensive rebound. And South Carolina will work some clock. Dawn Staley will stop the clock. Takes a timeout, 1:25 to go in overtime. We'll step aside for just a moment. Be right back in OT. South Carolina with the lead in overtime. They have possession in a three-point game. Aaliyah Boston was held in check in the first half. Had just 1 point. Picked up a couple of fouls in the first half. She picked up her fourth foul with 6:02 to go in the fourth quarter, but she has delivered in crunch time for South Carolina.
Want to get to is Aaliyah Boston in the second half. She's presented herself really well, moved without the ball, but she has been a beast on the offensive glass. Eric, 5 offensive rebounds alone for Aaliyah Boston, and that contributes to the 20 offensive rebounds that South Carolina has in this game.
See the second chance points there for South Carolina. Boston with another double-double. That is her 7th this year, her 6th in a row, the 37th of her career. The question now is, you said Missouri looked a little tired. They look exhausted to me. LaDasia Williams looks like she's given everything she has. Does Missouri have anything left in the tank here to get a stop and then try to convert on the other end here? Williams is actually coming out of the game. She just has nothing left, I think, for Missouri.
Well, Eric, they may not physically, but I know they do mentally and want to. And so I'm not saying this game is anywhere near being over because, as we've seen throughout this game, it's been grit and just fight by Mizzou. I have a feeling this is an offense-defense substitution for LaDasia Williams.
Henderson trying to back in. Shot clock is down to 3. Boston, no. And this rebound is controlled by Missouri. So they get the stop, and they'll walk it up as we close in on a minute to go in OT.
1 minute remaining in overtime. 1 minute.
Missouri will play it out. Troop. Frank on the reverse.
And that play
the team high 21.
Sorry, that play was designed for Frank to come around for that outside shot. Credit the junior for putting it on the ground and attacking to get those 2 points.
Henderson looks off the pass on the drive, was stopped, and Missouri's got it. Missouri just has 4 in the front court right now. Hansen will still try to take it to the hoop, and a timeout being called here by Missouri. Troop is still back behind the play. Remember, she got hit hard in regulation and was slow to get up, and she was still back behind the play, and I don't know if her teammates realized it because they were shorthanded. They were playing 4-on-5, and Troop is really hurt here. Troop tiptoeing on the sidelines, keeping in play, but you could see grabbing for that right calf as she did all she could to stay in bounds and not fall out of bounds, and they're going to carry her away from the bench here as Missouri takes a timeout. They've got 1 remaining. South Carolina on top by 1. Missouri trying to knock off a number 1 team for the first time in their program history, Christy.
I was going to say, as we learned at the end of regulation, most important thing for Mizzou is to get the ball inbounded cleanly. They don't want to risk anything. I'd be really weary of wherever Destiny Henderson is right now, but I'm going to say it again. I expect a weak side screen of some sort for Mizzou to get a shot.
Williams is back into the game with Troop out. Mizzou down by 1. Final seconds, overtime. Down to 4. Hansen in trouble. Hansen floats it up and drops it in. Missouri's on top. Missouri's going to win. Timeout with a tenth of a second to go. They will check the time. If this time is confirmed, South Carolina doesn't have enough time to do anything, and Missouri will have won in overtime. Officials are having a conversation right now.
And let's not forget, Mizzou does have a foul to give.
The play is on review for a possible clock malfunction.
Possible clock malfunction? Interesting. All right, let's take a look at what they could be looking at here. This could take a little while. So let's go through the sequence, Christy. First, Hansen with the go-ahead basket.
Well, as a coach, you always just want a shot opportunity. Hansen puts her head down, blows by three defenders over the outstretched weak side rotation of Aaliyah Boston to get the shot to fall.
Now with the clock. I think they're going to put a little time on. There's going to be enough time here for South Carolina
after review,
to do something.
The game clock is correct with 0.1 left on
Whoa.
The game clock.
Wow! I didn't see that. 0.1 on the clock. That's not enough time for South Carolina. You cannot score if there's 0.2 or less on the clock.
And combine that with Mizzou has a foul to give. So as soon as that ball comes in, you don't want to foul a shooter, obviously, but you get forward to get really aggressive going for the steal.
See Troop has come back to the bench area. Pinchin's going to call a timeout here. I mean, just to confirm, Christy, you can't do anything. With 0.4 left, you can catch and shoot. 0.3, you can tip, but 0.2 unless you can't score.
Yeah, so what some coaches will try to do is run, like draw an off-ball foul. But again, I go back to Mizzou's only got the three fouls.
I mean, if you're Missouri, just get out of the way. There's nothing you can do. But to take that rule one step further, 0.2 or less, you can't score. Dawn Staley will take a timeout. So they're trying to draw up something to get Missouri to foul, but as Christie's pointed out, three fouls left. So it's not going to result unless you can do a back-to-back plays. But if you're Missouri, run away. Stay away.
Well, and you saw just on that out-of-bounds play before the timeout, Missouri's just walling up to the bigs of South Carolina.
Anxious moments. Warren Hanson just wants to celebrate one more time. Both teams out of timeouts. This is it.
And you're seeing now, to your point, Eric, Mizzou's just backing off, trying to put everybody in that paint area to disrupt anything easy.
Henderson throws it towards the basket. That's it. Tipped in by Boston. That can't count, though. That can't count. You see the official bottom of the screen. Not enough time for that to count. Celebration at Mizzou Arena. The Tigers have knocked off number one, South Carolina. We talked in the overtime, Christy Thomas-Gundy, if Missouri had anything left in the tank. It looked like they were on vapors, but vapors is enough to get it done on their home floor tonight. And that's a thrill ride that Robin Pinchton loves right there, because Missouri has knocked off number one South Carolina.
Well, and I think if you're a Mizzou fan, you love that shot. Not only the sheer joy in the players' faces, you have the alums who are also celebrating this win with this team. I can't say enough about the heart, the grit, and the sheer will throughout not just 40 minutes, but 45 minutes here this evening of Mizzou.
The starters for Missouri played 91% of the available minutes. Haley Troop, one of those starters, was carried off the court in overtime, but she's on the court to celebrate with Sophie Cunningham and everyone else who wants to join in the celebration, because Missouri has knocked off number one South Carolina, 70-69 the final. Lauren Hanson, the hero, with the game winner in overtime. What a great start to the season for Christy Thomas-Gundy and our crew. I'm Eric Fried. Thank you for joining us. It's time for SEC Now.